Dear Ajahn, earlier you mentioned it can be quite sad to realize that form and perceptions and feeling are not self. I don't think I said that. I think the thing I was saying is what Ajahn and Nan was saying, is that when you realize that everything's destined to die, that's what he said is sad. And the other thing he said is the momentary flash of that kind of sadness, then the mind turns inward and experiences great peace. So it's not that you get stuck in the state of everything sad. It's a correct perception of the nature of conditions, of the conditioned world. It is a place with a lot of dukkha. Everybody does have to die. Death is usually unpleasant. So, you know, it's a correct perception to be sobered by that and saddened by that. But then what Ajahn Achalo was describing his process, seeing the sadness, samadhi is stabilized. And so he was in that state of upajara samadhi, having contemplated death consistently. He was in this state, like what that person described today. They're kind of cool, steady, peaceful experience, the most peaceful they've ever been. So Ajahn was experiencing that for 3 months. So when we talk about emptiness, it's not nihilism, it's emptiness of self, emptiness of the solid world. And the mind that perceives that emptiness is extremely content. So it's not, you don't stay in some stuck, sad state. You say you discover a profoundly serene, content state, because it's the seeing the nature of conditions. Really seeing the nature of conditions, the mind notices that which isn't conditioned. It is awareness that can notice conditions. And Ajahn Sumedho often says that which can know suffering isn't suffering. So in seeing that which has suffering as a pervasive characteristic, in really seeing it more and more consistently, that which sees it gets more and more and more contented, more and more full of rapture and bliss and tranquility and serenity and profound peace. So sadness is a step on the process. The next thing is like thinking, if my mum, if the mother is an empty entity in the wheel of samsara. So be careful how we understand empty. Realization of emptiness is blissful. So if recognizing that your mum is empty, that means her real nature is bliss. It doesn't mean that her real nature is dead. It's not. So I think what's happening is it's actually doubt hindrance proliferating in the mind to kind of come up with a reason to feel sad, not skillfully sad. So we have to be very careful. Basically, the more you see emptiness, he repeats many phrases, he says, the more you see the loathsomeness of the body, the more beautiful your mind becomes. The more you see emptiness, you know, not grasping at things as being solid, then the more, he doesn't say this, but this is my adding to that, the more full your heart and mind feels of qualities like bliss and rapture. So not grasping at conditions, the mind becomes liberated. So there's nothing to despair. And in terms of like your relationship with others, basically, you can reflect upon their ultimate potential. And if they're not enlightened, they're bound to be born and die, born and die, born and die. But their potential is to realize unshakable peace. So, no need to get depressed. Just try to help your mum, support your mum to practice. Then she won't be, she's not an empty entity, then she becomes an enlightened entity. And practice yourself, because as the more we practice and dedicate to merit, the more we benefit our parents as well. these kind of doubts and thoughts can only really be overcome by doing a lot of practice, basically. And the way I understood Ajahn Achalo's process anyway was, you do have to feel that sobering. I experienced a lot of it myself as a young monk. For the mind to be moved towards liberation, it has to become disenchanted with the things that it's grasping at in confusion. So, you know, if you're grasping at something, you're not going to let it go unless you see the downside of grasping. So you see the downside. That's what's happening when that sadness comes up. Like, oh, this isn't worth grasping because it's just going to die. And in letting go, the mind can come inwards and feel a lot of bliss, a lot of rapture. So, I hope that's helpful. Dedicate Mary.